Hello, I'm Ellie for Edu for Java, and this is tutorial number 5, in which we will talk about the instruction or sentence if, logic expressions, and logic operators. Before starting with the tutorial, I would like to correct a mistake in the tutorial number 4. When I defined the name of the Java package to organize classes, I made an error. Have a Java packages, a name with the domain, but the other way round. First, we put the domain. And then the name. Okay. Continue. As you can see, I've already changed it, and Eclipse has changed the content too. Perfect. New package. com.edu4java.tutorial5. Remember that the package goes with lowercase. Tutorial 5, remember that classes are written with uppercase. Let's check public static void main so that it creates the method main so that we can run the program. Let's delete this code that was generated automatically. Okay, the first thing I would like to explain is the concept of the program flow control. Let's see what's this. I hope you don't have this too. Well, I don't think it's important. Okay. Instruction 1. As you can see, I don't like to write a lot. Instruction 1, 2, 3, and 4. To run the program for the first time, you will have to do it from here. Right button, Run as Java application. In the console, we have the result of this small program. 1, 2, 3, 4. We have already seen this, but I do this so that you get an idea. The idea is the flow. The flow of a program is the order in which the instructions are executed. This first instruction it is executed first, and then this one, and then the third one, and so on. As you can see, this is correct. First, this one was printed and then the others. The instruction if asks for help with console space. You can choose this one, if condition, or this one, if else. Let's start with the if condition. This means that if what is inside the condition is true, whatever is inside will be run. Let's copy this. The instruction to inside. Now let's write a condition. Let's write a condition which is going to be false. 1 is bigger than 2. Here I am writing that 1 is bigger than 2, so what do you think? Is this 2? No. This will be false because 1 is smaller than 2. This is false. Let's run it. And as you can see, the instruction 1, 3, and 4 are printed, but the instruction number 2 is not printed. If we wrote 3 and we run it, the instruction number 2 is printed. Why? Because 3 is bigger than 2. So, because this is 2, this instruction will be run. Here we have 2. Now the concept of true and false. This is an expression which will have as a result true or false. True and false is a type of data called Boolean, which we'll see later on. Talking about the flow control, notice that we've changed the flow control. This instruction changes the order in which the instructions are executed. For example, here we can see that the instruction 1, 3, and 4 were executed, but not the 2. If here we put 3 again, all the instructions are executed. This condition changes the flow of the program. This is why these instructions are called flow control instructions. Do you remember that we had seen an else that we could choose an if or an if and else? Else, let's put here the instruction number 3. Okay, else. If this is true, we execute this, and if not, we execute this. Let's see if it's 2. 1, 2, and 4. Instruction number 1 was executed. It evaluated the condition 3 bigger than 2. Instruction 2 was printed. Instruction 3 was not printed because it was the if not. And it continues to 4. We can see that it's another way of changing the flow of the program. This instruction is going to be executed if this is false. If we write 1, we run 1, 3, 4. One, three, four. Okay. With this, I think we can see that the instruction if does. Let's do something a bit more complicated and see logic expressions so you don't get bored. Let's copy the code of the tutorial for. And let's copy it in our program. If you remember, scanner was an object to which we could ask for texts. It asked to write something on the console. We wrote on the console edu, for example, and return. This recovered this edu. It put into entrada entry, and after system.out showed mostrar lo escaneado, show the scanner. And this one printed edu, which was what we wrote in the first place. Let's change it a bit. We're going to create a program which asks for the age. I wrote age, edad, as an int type. Why? Because age is a number, it's not a string. Before it was a word. That's why we have an error. Next reads words. But thankfully, scanner has also a next int, which reads numbers. We could write escanear age, edad, mostrar la edad, show age, Here we write Ejda. Let's run it. Enter age, let's write 11, show age 11. If we had a bar and we had slow employees, we could like a program to know if they can sell drinks, alcohol to people or not. They're going to ask the age using this program. If we're going to use the second type, if else, if the age, Eda, is more than 18, I think this is the legal age to start drinking in most of the countries, so let's write 18. If age is bigger than 18, then he can drink, puede beber. If it's not so, no puede beber, he can't drink. Let's run it. Scanner age, escanear edad, let's say he has 17. It says, no puede beber, he can't drink. Mostrar la edad, show age, 17. Let's do a trick here. So it's in the same line. I'm taking out the print line. System.out has also a method called print, which doesn't change of line. Let's run it again. Age, edad, 21. Puede beber, he can drink. And show age, 21. Let's do this here too. Let's get rid of the print line so that it's all together in the same line. Age 11, he can't drink. Okay. Notice that this program is not really correct. Why? Scanner age 18. He can't drink. This is wrong. We had said that 18 was the age. This is because 18 is not bigger than 18. We are talking of the people who are 18 or more. This is a logic operator. And we're going to change it for this one, bigger equal. Edad age is bigger or the same, that's 18. Let's run it again, 18. Now he can drink. Let's write it right again, 17. He can't drink, no puede beber. This is quite intuitive, really. If this is true, this happens. If it's false, this happens. Here, for the first time, we are using a variable in the if expression. This variable is an int type, and when we're using this operator with another int, it returns a result which is an integer. No, sorry, true or false. Sorry, the time which YouTube gives for tutorials is finished. It will continue in tutorial 5.1, Java logic expressions and operators. Thank you.